Basket is good, number 22, Keegan Hayes. Basket is good for number 10, Nathaniel Eliason. Full timeout taken by the Hawks. Sign up at the 804 Coaches for Change table for a chance to win pizza for a year, Papa John's pizza for a year, potential to win that in a contest if you sign up at the 804 Coaches for Change table. That contest will take place at the halftime matchup of the next game, St. Christopher's taking on Hermitage. Foul on number 0, Tyler Latham. That's his first. Team 6. Collegiate is in the bonus. And at the line to shoot 2 for the Cougars, number 20. William Hershey. Second free throw is good from number 20, William Hershey. Concludes your third quarter. Your score, Cougars 51, Hawks 21.
But then I know it's growing strong.
Foul on number 3, Ian Nicholson. That's his first, team first for the Hawks. Foul on number 1 for the Cougars, Aiden Gregory. That's his second, team first. Substitution for the Cougars, taking in the game, number 30, Chase Anderson, and number 10, Patrick Abu. And number 5, Carter Epps. Charging foul on number 4, Ari McWilliams. That's his 4th, team 2nd for the Hawks. Traveling violation on the Cougars, Hawks basketball. It is good from number 10, Patrick Abu. Foul on number 1, Joel Nicholson. That's his 2nd, team 3rd. At the line, shoot 2 for the Cougars. Number 10, Patrick Abu. Substitution For the Hawks, checking the game, number 21, Andrew Dressler. Out of bounds. That'll be staying with the Cougars. Out of bounds. Collegiate basketball. Basket is good, number one, Joel Nicholson. Basket is good, number 11. Aiden Tremere. Staying with the Cougars. Out of bounds, that's gonna be Hawks basketball. Matchup. Your final score, Cougars 53, Hawks 25. Up next, St. Christopher's takes on Hermitage. All right, ladies and gentlemen, now time for our Henrico Sports Entertainment All Tournament Selections. Starting with the Hanover Hawks. Their selection is number 2, Riley Bain. For the Cougars All-Tournament Selection, scoring 16 points tonight on 3 3-pointers, the senior captain, number 2, Randolph Campbell. Tournament MVP, averaging 15 points in the tournament, number three, Frank McNally. For the tournament champions, the Collegiate Cougars! Now for our next game coming up, in 10 minutes, the Hermitage Panthers take on the St. Christopher Saints. Thank you.
Hello and welcome to Henrico Sports and Events Center. We have kind of a great game coming up for you guys. It's the Hermitage Panthers taking on your St. Christopher Saints. St. Chris coming into this game 7-2. They'd win last night. Very nice performance. Headlined once again by Brandon Jennings. He led the Saints with 19. And Hermitage there are going to be a very tough opponent for the Saints. Coming in 8-1 to this game. Nearly a 40-point win last night. I'm Edison Plumby alongside Harrison Fuller. Harrison, what do you think about this game?
I feel like it's going to be a tight game. You know, St. Chris is 7-2. Hermitage 8-1. You don't get to see many public and private matchups, but I feel like it'll be cool to see how the Saints size up here against the Panthers.
We have an awesome building and an awesome environment here at the brand new Henrico Sports and Events Center, so it's been awesome to be able to do these games the last 2 days. I was here last night, and it's a great building, great facility. They're going to have some big things here. Their first major thing, the A10 women's tournament is going to be here in March, so that'll be fun.
Yes, and we have an alumni as the PA, Austin Levin, class of 2023.
Yeah, he's moved on to Tulane now, but such a recognizable voice. I'm sure many of you guys are used to hearing him for the last 4 years at Scott Gym. Someone the Saints are going to need to watch out for tonight is going to be Eden Harvey. Last night he put up 18. He was the joint leading scorer with Cavante Williams. Harvey knocked down 43% of his three balls last night. Saints going to need to work to contain that. Early in the game last night, they did really struggle with the high press that was being thrown at them. Eventually, they did manage to get around it, and their offense clicked, as did their defense. And they came away with a 52-41 win. So this should be a great one here at this brand new Henrico Sports and Events Center.
Yes.
Starting five for the Saints, same as usual. Sonny Bridges, Brandon Jennings, Stuart Cosby, Kellen Welch, and Darius Gray.
Starters for Hermitage tonight are number 0, Tyson Scott. Number 1, Jaden Faircloth. Number 3, Eden Harvey. Number 4, Omar Washington. And number 21, Cavante Williams. This Hermitage team looks to be 80% seniors with, I think, two juniors on the team. One of them is Jaden Faircloth, who's starting, so a very old team. Gonna have to fill some big shoes next year.
Saints in the red, Panthers in the white. We're almost ready to go here. We apologize for the delay in this game. This game was supposed to be ending right about now, but there's a big delay with the traffic earlier with Metoica, and they got pushed back, and all the subsequent games have, but we are off here. Tip controlled by the Panthers, but not for long, as that's a quick turnover by Jaden Faircloth. Yeah. Not the way you want to start off a game.
Brandon Jennings just doing what he does best there, taking the ball, or stealing it, poking it out. VCU commit, very good on the defensive end, obviously. Very good on the offensive end. It's a very solid, well-rounded player.
It's Darius Gray. He can't finish, but Jennings goes up and taps it back in. Saints strike first.
Maybe tonight they'll utilize Darius Gray's size with the all-prep football player of the year, all the accolades from football, his 6'3 frame to back down Williams.
Is that three from Harvey is no good. It's going to be Sonny Bridges bringing it up. As Bridges in a little bit of trouble, gives it out. Kellen Welch puts up a three. He got it. Early 5-0 lead for St. Christopher's as Kellen Welch puts it in. So 5-0 Saints early in this one. Harvey back out for Scott. He'll drive. It's knocked away by Jennings. 2-on-2. Jennings goes up. He can't finish. Bridges with the rebound. He lays it in. Early 7-0 lead for St. Christopher's.
Just waiting for a Hermitage timeout here.
So 7-0 Saints. Just over a minute 30 into this one. Could not have asked for a better start. Faircloth. He drives on Welch, kicks it out, three-pointers up, and just rims out, but the offensive rebound. Scott got up a shot, but couldn't finish. It's with Bridges now. Right back to Welch. Cosby drives, turnaround jumper, no good. Gray on the offensive glass. He goes up through some contact, he finishes. 9-0 Saints to start off this game, and the Panthers need a timeout.
That's the way you start a game right there for the Saints. Give them a lot of momentum here, confidence to hopefully dismantle the Panthers.
So 30-second timeout by the Panthers. We'll be back. Welcome back. We are just over 120 seconds into this game, and St. Christopher's already out to a 9-0 lead as they go for the crown in the 804 Coaches Classic.
Unity bracket.
Here's Faircloth. He drives back to Scott. And finally, the Panthers have taken that lid off the hoop. It's Tyson Scott. First basket of the night.
Yeah, he came into this game with having 14 last night. So his 6'5 frame, they're looking to utilize him a lot.
It's Gray out for Bridges in the corner. Nice crossover, but goes off his foot. It's going to the Panthers. A lot of lines on the court, so this might be relatively confusing, but the pink line, that's going to be the three-point line that you're looking for. Jaden Faircloth gets a screen. He'll drive, kicks it out. Eden Harvey back to Faircloth. Nice pump fake. He gets into the lane. Blocked by Welch, but he lands out of bounds on the rebound. So it'll be staying with Hermitage. And something to note in this tournament, there is no shot clock.
Unlike the 30-second shot clock that St. Chris has.
As that shot from Kevontae Williams, no good. Welch in transition. He'll go up through some contact with no call, but Brandon Jennings on the second effort. That's been a big problem so far for Hermitage. Third time this game that the Saints have scored on a second opportunity. Jennings with two of those. Pass in for Williams. He'll go to work on Gray, and he lays it in.
He's trying to back down the All-Metro lineman there. It didn't work. Worked a little bit, but didn't get him to move very far. But still got a nice shot off.
Here's Stu Cosby. He has a pretty nice height advantage there on Faircloth. It's with Jennings now. Guarded by Omar Washington. He puts up a three over him. No good. Rebound by Tyson Scott. And really nice transition offense from Hermitage. As Omar Washington with the up and under. 11-6. Gray gives it to Jennings. Pull-up jumper. No good.
I don't know about you, but I feel like that's Brandon Jennings' signature shot, the pull-up from the elbow.
Yeah.
See him do that a lot this year.
Kick out. Three from Scott is up, and that's good. Just like that, after the disastrous start they got off to, Hermitage cut the lead down to two here. And that's a bad pass from Jennings, but it'll be staying with the Saints.
Number 13, Elijah Brandon checking in for the Saints. Darius Gray coming out. They're cousins, so another family member back on the court. No substitution for Hermitage. Someone was at the table, but didn't go in.
It's Welch He'll drive. Nice floater from Kellen Welch off the glass. Jaden Faircloth. You see Jack Dem getting ready to check in for St. Christopher's. Omar Washington. Good off the glass. Kellen Welch gets it to Stu Cosby. He puts up a three. He got it. Stuart Cosby, his first points of the night. As bad transition defense there from the Saints, however, as Eden Harvey. It's an easy lay.
Stuart Cosby pulled up from the college three-point line there. So I don't really know how many feet that is, but that was a good shot.
Here's Cosby again. This one no good. Long rebound out for Welch. Here's Bridges. Foul line jumper. Rattles home. This is a completely different Saints offense from what we saw last night. In that game, they didn't crack 20 points till just about 3 minutes left in the second quarter. Here, they're at 26 and a half minutes into the game. Omar Washington. And for Kevontae Williams, really nice post defense by Welch, but a better shot by Williams. Here's Bridges, back out. Welch puts up a three, no good. E.B. Brandon taps it out, but it'll be going to the Panthers.
Connor Campbell, Darius Gray, and Jack Dem checking in for the Saints. Number 11, Latrell Washington. And number 30, Cameron Hammond checking in for Hermitage. As well as number 10, Makari Ely.
Makari Ely. In for the Saints, number 22, Connor Campbell. And number 11, Jack Dem.
15-8 here is your score. Faircloth drives. He puts up a layup. It's blocked by Campbell. But it'll be staying with Hermitage. Knocked away by Jennings. Another steal for him. Brandon Jennings leaves it off. Connor Campbell goes up. He can't finish. Offensive rebound. Jennings, his shot no good, but he gets fouled, so he'll go to the line for two.
Yep. Brandon with steal, rebound, put back, gets fouled. You know, just great, like, play from him. I believe last night he had 17 points, 8 rebounds, like 9 assists, almost triple-double.
Yeah. First free throw is pure. Jennings has been so good defensively this year for the Saints. His offensive contribution also been massive, but I think he brings more on the defensive end as he's capable of shutting down essentially any player the other team has.
Yeah, seems like the Saints' whole entire game plan runs through him.
Both free throws are good from the VCU commit.
From number 3, Brandon Jennings. Substitution for the Saints. Checking into the game, number 32.
With 32, Nate Roberts checking into the game.
Sophomore center. He comes in for Gray.
Also, football tight end. Hoping to see some PT next year.
Here's Latrell Washington. He puts up a shot, no good. Jennings pulls down the board. Escapes some traffic. He's going to push. Jennings goes for the layup and the foul. Brandon Jennings with the and one.
Once again, steal, drive down there and put it up.
I don't know how he finished that. The contact resulted in the ball being knocked out of his hand, but somehow midair he recollected it and got it to go. So 22-15 here, now 23-15. Jennings once again playing a massive impact early.
Coach Jones trying to get Wally Jones to get a quick substitution in there. Missed it, but it's fine.
Eden Harvey tries to isolate on Jennings. Not something many people are very successful with as, let's see. They're going to say the whistle blew, before they called the foul on Jennings. So that'll be it for your first quarter. 23-15 your score. We'll be back for the second. Hello and welcome back to your second quarter. Saints looked very good in the first. Jumped out to a 9-0 lead. They now lead 23-15. Once again, their best player is Brandon Jennings, who can't finish there, but fight for the rebound. He gets it. Kick out for Welch. Thought about a three. Decides for a little pull-up jumper. That's no good. Two Panthers fight for the rebound, but it ends up with Darius Gray. And he will go... He go to the line? No, it'll be on the floor, so Jennings will inbound.
Darius Gray was just named to the first team All-Metro football team at O-line, so big congrats to him.
Yeah, he's a force down there.
Force to be reckoned with.
Jennings gets it in for Gray. Two men come in the post. Down for Jennings. Kicks it out. Welch puts up a three. He got it, Kellen Welch, as the Saints lead back up into the double digits.
I believe Kellen Welch has 7 points tonight.
Yeah, three and two
layups.
I believe he has two threes.
Maybe.
I might be mistaken. I believe, yeah. So double 10 digits. Early points for Welch. Sonny Bridges now, he has only 2 points on the night. It's been the Saints' second leading scorer this year behind Jennings. As he gives it off for Darius Gray. The pick and roll spin. Layup is good. 13-point lead for St. Christopher's right now. They're looking amazing here. Hammond back out for Macarielli. Corner three. No good. Offensive rebound by the Panthers. Blocked by Welch. And he'll come away with the rebound. 4-on-4 as there was a tie-up down there. It's with Bridges now. He's going to be fouled. And that'll be on the floor.
Foul on number 30. Cameron Hammond of the Panthers. That's his second.
Jennings inbounds, and great play as Bridges goes up and lays it in. Lead up to 15 now for St. Christopher's. Desmond Jones. Macarielli. Very stagnant offense right now. For the Panthers, down 15 early in the second quarter. Eden Harvey. That's going to be a foul. I believe they're going to get Brandon Jennings.
Foul number three for the Saints, Brandon Jennings.
Can I have Brandon Jennings getting into foul trouble tonight? Because he plays a vital role for this team, as we've said. I think that's one of the things he struggles with is sometimes he tries to go a little over the top on defense and ends up drawing a lot of fouls. But
yeah, only his first, but he's going to want to be careful to not pick up in a second or definitely not a third before half. Ooh, big collision there. But another thing for Jennings is if he's not in foul trouble, that gives him the freedom to be more aggressive on defense because let's say he's going into the fourth with one foul, can be a lot more aggressive. As there's a nice floater from Kevontae Williams. Panthers needed that as St. Christopher's was on a 9-0 run. It's Welch for Bridges. Floater is good.
Alim Bridges with the floater.
Desmond Jones. Corner three is no good. That was Omar Washington. The rebound by Cosby. Bridges is going to look to push. Floater, no good. Offensive rebound by Welch. Gives it back to Jennings, and he'll be fouled. That'll be on the floor, so Saints will inbound. Third team foul on the Panthers. Jennings. Turnaround jumper over two men. Bounces off the rim, but Gray with the offensive rebound. He'll go up and lay it in. Macariele, he's going to be fouled. Macariele go to the line. They got Cosby on that foul. First free throw was good. As is the second. 34-19.
Kellen Welch throwing the inbound in here. Saints going to break the full court press.
As that's knocked away from Bridges, but that'll be out. This is a look defensively that the Saints heavily struggled with last night. Later in the game, they did find a way to crack the press, but early their offense was really struggling. And even throughout the whole game, they only managed to put up 53, so...
Yeah.
Oh, what a pass from Gray. Jennings, well, hard foul.
There's a press breaker for
you. Yeah.
Him.
I can't think of a better way for the Saints to break the press. It's great design from Coach Jones.
Hard foul there from Omar Washington.
So Jennings go to the line for two more.
Maybe I got confused on what season it was. Thought he was playing football. don't even tackle anybody in basketball, but. Smart foul there.
First free throw from Jennings, rims out.
Substitution for the Panthers. Checking the game, number two, Jason Grant.
Second free throw from Jennings. This one rattles home. 16-point lead for St. Christopher's. For Hermitage, they really need to start cutting into this deficit. You don't want to go into the half down 18-20. It feels a lot better, as that's going to be a foul on Bridges away from the ball.
Seemed like it was a little flop there from the Missouri.
Yeah, it might have been.
I don't really think Sonny pushed him that hard, but it's fine.
Yeah. So, due to the foul being away from the ball, that'll be just an inbound instead of three free throws. And that's knocked away by Cosby. One man to beat. Stu Cosby goes up and gets maybe a generous foul call. I didn't see much contact from up here, but I'm sure he's not complaining.
Nope.
So, another turnover by the Panthers, and Cosby will go to the line for two.
Stuart Cosby, lengthy shooter. See if he can make these.
First free throw can't go down. Second from Cosby, also misses, so he goes over two at the stripe. Timeout taken by Hermitage. We'll be back. During the break, we're going to get a view of former Saint Austin Levin. You guys heard his voice for 4 years at Scott Gym. He's now moved on to Tulane after graduating, but we appreciate Austin's work here at this tournament. He does a great job on the PA. So welcome back. Hermitage down 16, about halfway through the second quarter, as that is going to be off of Cosby's foot, I believe. So staying with the Panthers.
Panthers haven't really been able to find their groove tonight. Had a lot of turnovers, lack discipline, but it's fine. They'll hopefully carve into this deficit a little bit. Obviously want Saints to win, but hope to see Hermitage play well.
Faircloth, step back three from well outside. He puts it in.
That was a nice shot there. He's only 5'8", but he's the only junior in the starting lineup, so next year, all eyes on him for Hermitage.
Here's Jennings. He puts up a three, and he answers. Brandon Jennings, his first three of the night. The Saints lead right back up to 16. Once again, we mentioned the three-point line that we're looking at as a foul's called, but the three-point line that these players need to look at is the pink one. If you guys can see it on the court, it's pretty faint. But, yeah, good work from Harrison Fuller there to zoom in. But the three-point line the players are looking at is that pink one, not the blue one. And those last two shots from Jennings and Fairchild, both behind that college three-point line. Yeah. Here's Faircloth. Hesitation and a nice pass in. Layup is good from Jason Grant.
That was a nice cut there from Jason Grant. Good assist, good vision.
Here's E.B. Brandon. Kellen Welch for Jennings. Step back three, air ball, and E.B. Brandon can't grab the rebound. Nearly runs over the camera woman.
Yep. I don't know if she should be sitting there, though.
Yeah, it's a little bit of a dangerous place, but.
Yeah.
Darius Gray comes on, Bridges comes off. Just under 2:30 to play in the second quarter. Saints lead by 14. It's been an incredible performance from them against a very good Hermitage team. They're coming into this game 8-1, 40-point win last night. But the Saints have done everything they've needed to do. So here's Faircloth. Kicks it back out for Grant. Back to Faircloth. He puts up a three. He got it.
Another deep three there from behind the college three-point line.
As Saints struggle to get it in for a second, but they do get it to Jennings finally. Brandon Jennings kicks it out. E.B. Brandon in the corner. He puts up a three, and he answers.
E.B., also a talented football linebacker.
As Jennings nearly comes up with a steal, and that's knocked away by Gray, but once again, the Panthers come up with it. It's Eden Harvey as he traveled.
Offensive foul on number three, Eden Harvey. That's his first.
Sonny Bridges checking in the game for Stuart Cosby.
Jennings does a nice job to break the double team. It's with Bridges, crossover, jumper, no good off the back rim. Rebound, Gray, he goes up, his shot blocked, and Bridges can't come up with the rebound, so they'll be going to the Panthers.
That was a nice crossover move there from Sonny. Made his defender go the other way.
Yeah, that's his go-to move, and it's been very successful, not just tonight, all season.
And all most of his career, he's been on the team since he was a freshman, junior now, junior captain. Big honor to be named as a captain's junior here.
Yeah. One of, if not the only captain as a junior. I know in the fall there weren't any.
I believe the futsal captains are Jack Bleacher and Stephen Bashara, two more juniors.
That's going to be a foul on Gray. Fifth of the half for the Saints, so Eden Harvey will be going to the stripe.
Appeared there, he just threw him.
That's one way to describe it. As the first free throw from Harvey is down. I think the most impressive thing from the Saints tonight is how every time Herman had just come up with a big bucket, Saints have answered.
Yes.
His second free throw is good. 29-41 is your score here. So it's Welch. He needs to get rid of it. Gets it to Jennings. Kicks it out in the corner. Brandon for three. Stepped on the line.
Dim checking in for Brandon here.
Checking in game number 11, Jack Dim. 41 to go. And these last 41 seconds are very important for Hermitage, is the difference between going into the half down 15 versus going in the half down 9 would be massive for them. Faircloth, he drives, knocked away by Welch, but he gets it right back. And that pass, knocked away by Gray, and when Jason Grant got it back, his foot was on the line, so Saints will have it with 16 seconds to play.
Stuart Cosby checking into the game for Darius Gray.
Saints probably will hold for that final shot. 16 seconds to play in the first half. Sonny Bridges gets it up for Welch, gives it over to Jennings. Double teamed, he needs to get rid of it. He's fouled.
Tyson Scott there, not very happy with that call. Please didn't do anything wrong, but
he'll go to the stripe for two. 7 seconds to play.
Once again, Brandon back at the line.
First free throw from Jennings. Can't get the roll. It's his second miss of the night from the line.
Freshman Brady Burnett going to the table to check in, maybe for the shooter here.
As the second from Jennings also misses. Cosby fights for the rebound, and it'll be going to Hermitage. 5.5 to play.
I believe Brady Burnett has a very basketball family. I think his dad is the head coach for John Marshall, who I think is 15th in the nation.
Yeah, they
St. Chris played last year.
They were number one when the Saints played them last year.
Yeah, they're legit.
Yeah. Game didn't go how the Saints wanted, but
nope.
It was a good comp. As that layup to beat the horn, no good. I don't think that Williams got it off, but it doesn't matter either way as it falls, no good. 21-49 Saints lead. Very impressive half from them. Stay with us. We'll be back for the second half.
Just need one. Nike, Adidas, whatever. If you've already shot, you can't come back. We need somebody new. We need somebody new. Five people, we need somebody new. Somebody new. You can't be a basketball player. You can't be a basketball player. You can't be a basketball player. It's too easy. You can't be, oh, here we go. Yep, you can't be a basketball varsity player. No varsity players. No varsity players. Yep, yep, come on. Yep, I see. Yep. $150. Four. I need two more. Two more. No varsity players. Two more. Here we go. We're good. All right. NBA 3. NBA 3. Come on, fans. Give them a little love. Give them a little love. That was simple. That was simple. Put them in the game. We'll still have some for our other contestants. Here we go. Let's see what they got. Yep. Ah, nice try. Nice try. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Golly. Put this guy in the game. I like it. Here we go. Yep. Here we go, last two. Yes, ma'am, here you go. I like it. She's picking her spot. She knows what to do. Here we go, from the side. Oh, here we go. Last contestant, last contestant. Little St. Chris swag. Here we go, clap it up for him, clap it up for him. I think it's going in. I feel good about it, I feel good about it. One more, one more. One more, here we go. Ah, good job. Ladies and gentlemen, give them all a round of applause. Please, before you leave, supporting 804 Coaches for Change, go put a positive quote on our wall of love, our wall of positivity. Please leave us with something. Thank you so much.
Hello and welcome back to the second half. St. Christopher's with a very good first half. They got out to a 9-0 lead. That's a lead they have never given back. They lead 41-29 at the break. We hope that the second half goes as well as the first did for them. I'm Edison Plumbee alongside Harrison Fuller. Harrison, what were your thoughts on that first half?
Saints played really well. A lot of teamwork there, not just Brandon Jing scoring the ball. Saw Kellen Welch with 10. Sonny adding in a couple. Darius adding in a couple. Whole like team game.
Some great defense by Jennings. Kicks it out. It's Faircloth. Williams in the paint. Knocked away by Welch. That's going to be staying with Hermitage. Omar Washington, he drives on Cosby. Washington took about four steps, but apparently got the pass off before, as now he goes up and he smokes the layup. Had a pretty good look, but couldn't finish it off as two men come for Jennings.
Then he goes and gets the foul. No, I think a little mad that he missed the shot there. Body got hit in the face.
Yeah, it looks like he's holding his eye, and now he's coming out.
Hermitage coach just said that his team is being outplayed by St. Chris. I feel like that really sums up the whole entire night for St. Chris.
Saints have been better on both sides of the ball, been better effort-wise.
Less mistakes.
Yeah, been better in every facet of the game as Welch puts up a three. Somehow doesn't fall. Would have been a huge start to the second half, but the shot that was looked almost down somehow rims out. As Williams locked up by Gray. Nice give and go as he finishes it off.
You see Kevontae Williams there being very patient, making Cosby jump, and then just laying it up. Nice patience there.
Bridges has it knocked away. Faircloth, pull-up jumper from the free throw line. Off the front of the rim, no good. Gets his own rebound. Gets it out. Three is up. No good. Jennings skies for the rebound.
I don't know if that was a good shot there. Hand in his face, and he's about at the NBA three-point line. Could have taken a better shot there.
Jennings, some really nice dribbling. Couldn't get the jumper to fall. 10-point lead for St. Christopher's. And for Williams, that's going to be a foul on Welch. Saints first of the half. Eden Harvey tried to pull up over Jennings, but Brandon did a great job to get a hand in his face. Decides to pass out of it, and that's going to be a foul. Let's see whether they got Gray or Cosby. They're going to call it on Gray.
You're not going to have much luck backing down Darius there. It's like trying to move a brick wall. So I think they got to notice that.
Their best hope might be doing just what they did there, drawing a foul. As with Jaden Faircloth now, 10-point lead for the Saints. Faircloth drives, falling away, air ball. Not a great shot there as he had two men in his face. So Bridges now, he drives, leaves it for Gray. He can't come up with a pass. Saints, some sloppy possession. As now Fairchild goes up, he's fouled. He will go to the line for two. Chance to cut the lead back into single digits as E.B. Brandon set to check in now.
Yep. Elijah Brandon was awarded a present in the Christmas chapel this year. Picture of Stephen Curry, I believe one of his favorite players, and sometimes he plays like him with his shooting mentality. EB's a character around school, everyone loves him.
The first free throw rolls off the rim. So lead for now remains in double digits as Brandon does check in for Welch.
You can see the bench mafia over here. Braxton Bourne, Wright Hilbert, and Charlie Suskin every time getting up off the bench and clapping for their teammates.
He goes 0 for 2 at the line. It's with Jennings now. Lead is 10 for the Saints in a game they've controlled all night. As here is E.B. Brandon now. Gives it back out to Cosby. With Jennings in for Gray. He'll go to work. Darius Gray goes up. His shot rejected by Kevontae Williams. It's Faircloth. He'll go up. Blocked by Jennings. He comes up with the rebound. 3-on-2 fast break. Here's Jennings. He goes up and he lays it in. Brandon Jennings goes coast to coast. Lead back up to 12.
He's like the Energizer Bunny. I mean, he just like never stops. Always just running around, have the ball in his hands, stealing it, shooting, whatever he needs to do.
First points of the half for the Saints there, as they now lead 43-31. It's the three up from Kevontae Williams, no good. Rebound Cosby.
I think they'll let him shoot that every single time. Didn't look very confident when he shot that.
No, they left him wide open.
Yep.
As foul called on Tyson Scott there. Second of the half on Hermitage. Here's Jennings in for Gray. He'll go to work. Blocked again. Kevontae Williams been a defensive force tonight. His fourth block.
Darius Gray not happy with the call there. I think he thinks it should be a shooting foul. Says something to the ref. He's got to check himself because sometimes high school refs like to call technicals and fouls for mouthing off to them.
Yeah. I think an issue for Gray sometimes when he's trying to get foul calls is that he's just so much stronger. As Saints take a timeout, but this is something you see in the NBA sometimes, as some of the stronger players in the league, they do such a good job at just brushing off the contact that they don't really sell the calls. And
yeah.
That leads to them not getting calls that they maybe should be getting. But 4:07 to play. Saints lead by 12. We'll be back after the timeout.
Whoops. Welcome back from the break. St. Chris up 43-31 over Hermitage. 4:02 left in the third quarter.
Darius Gray inside as he traveled, apparently.
Also ran over number 21.
Yeah.
I don't know if you want to take a charge from him.
Darius.
A lot of heart there from 21.
Yeah. You love to see it, but I'm sure his chest doesn't feel great after absorbing that hit.
Nope. Looks like Darius getting a little up close on him.
Has got his hands in there as Tyson Scott doesn't count, but he nails a three from about 35 feet.
Darius' third foul of the night.
Not something you want to see.
I believe that's – I think it might be his third this quarter. So he very unhappy with – the way the game's being called. But all you can do is fix it.
So three on the Saints star big man. Nate Roberts checks in for him. We'll see if Hermitage tries to go in the paint more. Only 4 points scored this quarter as Roberts got his arms tangled up with Williams. Four fouls on the Saints. So Williams will go to the line.
Hermitage already in the bonus.
Nate Roberts, that's his first, team fifth. At the line, shoot two.
Williams at the line.
First free throw from Williams, no good.
You can tell he's a big man. Shooting form there. Seems like he just pushed the ball at the very end. Guess he likes to stay in the paint.
The second is good. So only the third point of the quarter for Hermitage. As Bridges has it knocked away. Looks like a lot of contact.
Nice play there with a little roll from Sonny.
Yeah, we'll be staying with St. Christopher's. Cosby needs to pick out a pass. He finds E.B. Brandon. Back to Jennings. It's Brandon Jennings. He drives. He goes up. Tough finish, no good. Gets his own rebound, and that one falls.
The second chance points for the Saints have been killing Hermitage tonight. I believe Brandon, I think it's his fifth bucket off of his own rebound.
Yeah, Hermitage really needs to clean up that rebounding. As nice work there from Nate Roberts to knock it away. Tyson Scott, he kicks it out. Faircloth for three, no good. Rebound Roberts. It's a big 3 minutes here, and this could be make or break for Hermitage. Down 13 right now, as a bit of a unnecessary foul from Latrell Washington. It's going to be the third of the half on Hermitage.
The Panthers, Latrell Washington, that's his second team third.
I think the Panthers are shifting to more of like a lockdown, lock-off defense on Brandon. With Washington, as you can see, he's kind of face-guarding him when he doesn't have the ball, but not really working too well.
It's Jennings. Trying to create some space.
Cosby wide open in the corner.
Jennings doesn't see him, but he goes up. Tough finish, can't get it. But E.B. Brandon with the rebound. Long two, no good. And, Nate Roberts goes crashing into Wally Jones.
Nate gets thrown into the bench there by number 11, Latrell Washington. You can see Gavin Johnson, the manager, not too visibly happy with that. Seemed like that was a little anger foul. Not like he was going for the ball. Did that on purpose, seems like. He's a little mad.
Refs still conversing. This might be a flagrant.
I mean, I'd call it a flagrant, but I guess I'm a little biased.
We are awaiting the call.
Intentional foul on number 11, Latrell Washington.
So that's going to be a flagrant on Latrell Washington.
Yeah, I don't really know what they're arguing about. It was kind of obvious that he threw him into the bench.
Yeah.
Uncalled for. It's not something you want to do for the team. Hurts the team. Jennings obviously going to take the free throws for the Saints. We'll see how Washington's emotions, see if we can keep him in check again.
As the refs do blow a whistle now. I think they're discussing the number of free throws. It's usually a flagrant. It's one free throw and ball. Well, they're going to say Nate Roberts has to take the free throws. So I believe how this is going to go is that Roberts will take the two free throws for just the foul that happened, and then I believe Jennings will get to take one for the flagrant, or the Saints will just get the ball back. Not exactly sure. In the NBA, it's a shooter of your choice gets to take the free throws, as Roberts misses both. So the Saints will get to inbound here.
Elay. And Washington checking in for Washington, and Scott.
Here's Jennings in the corner. Brandon Jennings, one jab, goes in, kicks it off for Bridges. Pulls it back, his jumper's good.
Step back.
Saints lead by 15. Wide open three is good. Makari Eliu, big shot.
Don't really want to leave him open in the corner again.
Every time Hermitage has hit a three, this seems like the Saints have come down to answer. They need a big stop here. Lead down to 12. It's with Bridges. Gives it to Cosby. Back to Jennings. Foul will be called on the floor.
I don't know if that was, looks like he did the charge call there, but I don't think it was a charge.
Oh, wow, they're going to call a foul on Bridges. I thought it was going to be for some of the contact going against Jennings, but apparently not.
Dim checking in for Brandon.
Inside for Kevontae Williams. Roberts booked.
I think that's Nate's second foul.
It is.
The Saints big men. I don't know who's up next for big men. Maybe it's Harrison Miller. But the big men are in trouble. Because it seems like there have been a lot of fouls called this quarter.
Yeah. As another miss there from Kevontae Williams. The second free throw, well short. It's an ugly miss as Bridges has it.
Cosby's wide open in the corner. Doesn't want to give it to him.
Sonny Bridges, minute 23 to play. He drives, kicks it off for Roberts. His shot looked like Williams altered it, but strong finish from Roberts as he finishes through some contact on the ball.
You can see the bench gets very excited when Nate scores. You see Braxton Bourne get up and flexing after that strong bucket. Braxton Bourne with the buzz cut.
Williams inside. Layup, no good. Jennings has Cosby up ahead. He goes up, hop step, and one! Stuart Cosby with a huge basket. 52 seconds to play in the third quarter. Saints lead up to 16.
Fourth foul on Omar Washington. They might want to sub him out here so he doesn't get fouled out, because I believe it's five fouls.
It is five fouls. Cosby's free throw, no good. So lead will stay at 16. Harvey. Just over 30 seconds to go in the third quarter. Makari Eliu back to Desmond Jones. Once again, no shot clock, so theoretically Hermitage could hold for the final shot, and they will take a timeout, and we will be back. Welcome back here. Just over 25 seconds to play in the third quarter. Harvey, he dumps it off for Kevontae Williams and
Jennings knocking it out of bounds, yeah, using his pure athleticism, high vertical.
Once again, active hands from the junior guard. excuse me, senior guard. Hammond finishes it off. Just over 10 seconds to play. We'll see what the Saints can come up with. Clock down to 5. I'm not sure if Jennings knows it. 3 seconds. Jennings splits 2 defenders. Gets one up. Brandon Jennings just misses. I don't think he got it off in time. But that will do it for your third quarter. 51-37 St. Christopher's. We will be right back. Hello and welcome back. Saints lead by 14 going into the fourth. Some question between the officials. But we are off here. 8 minutes to play. Saints lead by 14. It's a big stretch coming up for the Panthers. They need to start cutting into this lead quick. So here's Gray. Playing on 3 fouls, kicks it out. Welch puts up a 3. No good. Rebound by Cavante Williams. As layup, no good. Rebound Jennings. He sends it ahead for Cosby, or excuse me, for Bridges, but a foul was called. And probably a smart foul by Cavante Williams as
yeah, that would. Brandon probably has a double-double in this game.
Yeah.
With rebounds and points. He's flying around, catching every loose ball, just doing what he does best.
Gets it over to Sonny Bridges. Kellen Welch in for Gray. He'll go to work. No good. Too strong off the back iron. Low scoring third quarter. We went into it with the Saints leading 41-29. We come out of it with the Saints leading 51-37. As that's a nice layup from Cameron Hammond. Panthers still have some hope. Only down 12, but they need points quick. And they need stops as well. So it's with Bridges. Gives it over. Jennings, 3 men in his face. Jennings goes up strong, and he finishes. Brandon Jennings with another basket. Saints lead back up to 14. You know, down 14 points. The Panthers really cannot afford to be going basket for basket. They need stops.
Seems like Saints have had a consistent 13-14 point lead over them tonight. I guess proving that private school, well, can't say that, but this private school is better than this public school.
So have to tie up there. Or no, they're going to call a foul on Jennings, his second of the night. Three is up. No good.
Stuart Cosby using his length there to put hand in his face while put a hand in number 10 Makari Ely's face while he's shooting. Drops the shot.
Welch needs to get rid of it. There's a lot of pressure. Gets it to Bridges. Goes up strong, and he finishes through some contact. Sonny Bridges. What a finish from him. Saints lead by 16.
See him flex there after that bucket. Something worthy to flex over. Nice shot there by Sonny. Or nice finish.
Saints doing a great job to hopefully wrap up this game, but that's not something they like to see. Missed free throws are usually a big way for teams to get back into a game, as that's layup no good, and Welch called for a foul. Oh, and excuse me, that's going to be on Gray. That's his fourth. So
Connor Campbell checking in for Darius Gray, I believe. Hopefully Saints can pull away here and get some guys in the game like Zach Davila, Harrison Miller, Brady Burnett, Wally. Some of the guys don't really get to play as much.
First free throw is good for Williams. Yeah. I want to see Wright Hilbert get some run.
Yep. SID leader, captain, yeah, along with Edison here.
He was up here helping us get ready before the game during the collegiate match. It's both free throws are in. Go check out his media account on Instagram, Right H Media. He does a great job there. A lot of the promotional things you see are going to be from him, as Connor Campbell's three no good. Another offensive rebound from Jennings. He goes up. He can't finish. Gets another board, and now he's going to the line. Brandon Jennings unstoppable tonight on the offensive glass. Yet another rebound for him, and two free throws coming up.
Yeah, he might get over 20 rebounds tonight.
Yeah.
He's probably got like 15 by now.
First free throw is good.
Tyson Scott checking in the game. Seems like there appears to be a fan for Hermitage screaming in every one of Saints free throws saying, "Let's go, Herm."
I don't know if you can hear them again. He was yelling for them to box out. Did not do that very well, as Welch got his hands on the ball first, but they end up coming away with the loose ball. Jaden Faircloth down 15. Five possession game. They need points quick. Faircloth kicks it out. Deep three-pointers up. No good. Rebound Welch.
Yeah.
Bridges up ahead for Cosby. He'll drive. Stuart Cosby lays it in. Lead up to 17 now for St. Christopher's. As one hand on the trophy for them. Really nice defense from Connor Campbell. Corner three. No good from Makari Alley, but poor rebounding from the Saints. It's going to lead to a jump ball. Arrow is going towards Hermitage.
Elijah Brandon checking in the game for the Saints, or for number 10, Kellen Welch.
Corner three is up, and that is good. Eden Harvey with a big shot. Lead down to 14. It's do or die now for Hermitage. Down 14, 4 minutes to play. It's Jennings, he drives, pulls back, jumper, no good. Rebound by the Panthers, out in transition. It's Harvey, he goes up, and that is going to be a call to block by Jennings. Wow. Goes up through some more contact. Refs letting them play. as I was very surprised to not see a goaltend called on Brandon Jennings there.
That Usain Bolt over here stretching.
We appreciate all you guys who've been very active in the chat tonight.
Zach Murphy.
Yeah, he's moved on to playing at Longwood.
I guess you want to see a shout out of his friend right here, Evan Wilson, or sorry, Evan Fisher.
Yeah.
The Marion Washington tennis player, and then Evan Fisher and Evan Wilson together, two Evans.
Yeah. Evan Fisher, part of that state championship tennis team last year. He was their number one. So timeout taken. We will go to break. 3:44 to play. Saints lead by 14. Welcome back. Saints lead 58-44.
Looks like someone's getting escorted out by the police over there.
Oh, wow. Not sure what's going on here, but... Not sure exactly what's going on. Not sure what exactly... going on over there. So Saints lead by 14, 3:44 to play. Here's Bridges. Kellen Welch. It's Cosby. And for Jennings, he'll go to work. Spins, puts it up off the glass and good. Brandon Jennings, another basket on the interior for him. Lead up to 16. Three-pointers up from Harvey, and he got it. Cuts it down to 13. Excuse me. Yeah, that will be a three. Here's Bridges now. He'll drive. He'll go up. And one, Sonny Bridges. What a finish from him. Huge basket. Saints lead 62-47 now.
Once again, Sonny with a nice and one finish. Seems like the Saints have been able to finish their and ones tonight. Number four, Omar Washington is fouled out of the game. Latrell Washington in. Maybe brothers there. Correlation with the last name. Don't know, but four foul beast, Darius Gray checking back in.
So that free throw, no good. Excuse me, having some issues with the clock here.
Yeah, we have Hermitage's parents are screaming about something.
Yeah, not sure what they're on about, but basket is good there. Lead down to 13. Here's Bridges, kicks it out. Brandon thought about a three, didn't take it. E.B. Brandon over for Sonny Bridges. Saints can slow it down. It's a five-possession game. And for Cosby, knocked away, but a foul called with 2:26 to play.
Foul on number three, Eden Harvey. That's his second. The Saints are getting the bonus, and at the line, shoot two to the Saints. Number five, Eden Cosby.
No, it's getting late, 10:34. All these fouls are not helping. Just get on the road and get home tonight.
The free throw from Cosby, no good.
Substitution for the Saints. Checking in the game, number 35, Darius Gray.
Aiden Reagan, visibly mad in the chat. He makes some of the graphics as well as Wright. Gotta give him some credit.
Aiden, you do a great job, man. We appreciate you. As lead up to 14 now. Eden Harvey lost it for a second. In for Washington. As it's E.B. Brandon up ahead. He'll go up and he'll miss it. But Cosby comes down with the board and he will finish it off. Lead up to 16 now, and that might have been the dagger for Hermitage.
Yep. Saints have been really good tonight on the offensive end, getting boards, putting it back up, something that Hermitage has not been able to do.
Shot no good. And Scott. That's going to be a foul called.
The other Washington, four fouls tonight.
Brandon Jennings. Correction, Latrell Washington is now at five fouls.
Oh.
He's been disqualified.
Latrell Washington also disqualified. Sorry about that. Both the Washingtons are disqualified. Number two, Jason Grant will come in for him.
Free throw, no good.
Once again, the Hermitage dad saying something. Trying to act smooth. But everyone really knows his intentions there. Laughing.
As Jennings misses both. Bridges tried to sky in for the rebound, but couldn't come up with it. As I'm not sure if Jennings got a hand on that, but they'll call a foul.
Foul number three, Brandon Jennings. That's his third, team third. At the line is two for the Panthers. Number three.
I want to give a quick shout out to Gavin Johnson, water boy slash manager for the St. Chris basketball team, keeping the team hydrated. Despite his knee injury, he is getting around and helping the team out.
So minute 29 to play. Second free throw, no good. Rebound by Gray. Up for Sonny Bridges. Lead up 2:16 now for St. Christopher's. They have one hand on the trophy. There's a foul is going to be called against E.B. Brandon. They'll say he pushed off.
Team substitution for the Saints. Taking the game, number 11, Jack Dabb, and number 10, Helen Welch.
As kick out to the corner. Grant thought about it, decides to drive. Nice finish from him. As timeout taken by Hermitage.
Timeout there a little unnecessary.
Yeah.
Minute and 6 seconds left, down by 14. Just let everyone go home.
But we will be back. Minute six, Saints lead, 65-51. So welcome back. Saints just have to hold on to the ball. As here's Bridges. He'll go up, knocked away, staying with St. Christopher's, however. Lead is 14, under a minute to play.
Theoretically, St. Chris could just run four corners offense here because the shot clock. But
yeah, if they want to, they could theoretically hold the ball for these last 58 seconds, but I don't think that's something Coach Jones would want them to do.
Nope.
Here's Jack Dem in for Bridges. Inside Cosby was wide open with the pass, a little bit off target, so 51 to play. Seconds to play as foul called on Cavante Williams.
Gonna double team Brandon there.
So here's Bridges, gets it over to Cosby. Back in for Bridges, hasn't knocked away. Jennings got a hand on it, but falls with the Panthers. Faircloth out. Jones for three, no. Rebound ripped down by Cosby. Here's Jennings. Dem in the corner. Thought about a three as timeout taken by Coach Jones. We will be right back. Welcome back. 25 seconds to play. This one just about over. Saints holding on to a 14-point lead. Here's Jennings. He'll go up, and he will score. Brandon Jennings, probably his final points of the night. He's put on a master show tonight.
I believe he'll be named All-Tournament Team MVP.
There's a wide-open three there. It's no good. Jennings gets it up to Dem, and that will do it. St. Christopher's, your 804 Coaches for Change Community Classic champions as they take down Hermitage 67-51. I'm Edison Palumbi alongside Harrison Miller with SCC TV. Excuse me, Harrison Fuller. We thank you all for tuning in, and that is it.
Happy New Year.
Your final 67-51. We hope you guys have a happy New Year, and for all the students tuning in, hope you guys enjoy your last 4 days of break coming up. Thank you all for tuning in.